This video will introduce PubChem as a source for resolving conflicting safety information. PubChem gathers information from many different sources. Constantly being updated, it is a good source for current data about pure chemicals. To find the PubChem website, type the name into any search engine. Once you are there, search by name or CASRN. We will use acetic acid as our example. The initial results page will show basic information. In some cases, may give multiple substances that could match your search term. Select the chemical you want information about. Notice that glacial acetic acid is a synonym, because the PubChem database is for pure chemicals. The compound summary page has a wide range of information about acetic acid. Note the blue border on this page. PubChem Laboratory Chemical Safety Summaries, or LCSSs, are excellent resources for evaluating conflicting information or filling in missing information from safety data sheets. The link is just below the pictograms on the compound landing page. When you click on the link to the substances LCSS, note that the border changes to orange. This provides a visual reminder that you are in the LCSS. The sections in the LCSS, which you can see in the contents on the right, are determined by the information available to PubChem, and do not necessarily match the section numbers in an SDS. In each section, if multiple sources have reported information, you will see the number of sources just below the section header. For example, in the GHS classification section, we see that acetic acid had information reported from 6 various regions, countries, or agencies. Selecting View More provides details. In this new window, you see the GHS information from each of the sources. The European Chemicals Agency, ECHA, or ECHA, is the only report where you can see statistics on collected information from companies. In their section, we can see that 4,861 companies reported information about acetic acid. While nearly 100% agree that acetic acid is a flammable liquid and vapor, H226, and causes severe skin burns and damage to the eyes, H314. Only about 15% report serious damage to the eyes, H318. A possible interpretation of this is that, since H314 was already reported, it was not necessary to include H318. When a hazard is widely reported, you should make sure to consider it in your work. If a hazard is less widely reported, you should evaluate for your situation whether that hazard is relevant. Due diligence suggests that protection for eyes would be suitable for laboratory work with acetic acid, even for the much lower concentration of vinegar. The bottom two reports are from NITE CMC, which is the Japan Chemical Management Center. If you open the information out, you see that one set of data was reported in 2006, and one was reported in 2009. Note that the Japanese reporting agency lists more hazard statements than the other reporting entities. Assigning more severe health hazards is common for NITE CMC. If you want to err on the side of caution, review the report from Japan. Similarly, you can use the LCSS to check for conflicting information from other sections of the SDS, which can be useful if your manufacturer's SDS had a lot of no data available listings. Some sections will report adjustments for form or concentration, which can be helpful. Recall that PubChem primarily provides information for pure chemicals, so this data is for glacial acetic acid, and will not apply to vinegar, which is a dilute 5% solution of acetic acid. In conclusion, by gathering information from many different sources that are constantly updated, PubChem can be a good way to get a bigger picture. Knowing which safety information is most frequently identified, and finding follow-up information, helps you make informed decisions about what the prudent precautions are. For you, your colleagues, and your students.